Are you ready to unlock the true potential of automation? In this video, I'm going to show you how to connect Power Automate Desktop and ChatGPT using an API. This powerful combination can help you streamline your workflow, improve productivity, and take your automation game to the next level. Whether you're a beginner or an advanced user, this tutorial is packed with valuable information and step-by-step instructions. So, sit back and get ready to learn how to revolutionize your tasks with Power Automate Desktop and ChatGPT. Before we dive into connecting Power Automate Desktop and ChatGPT using the API, let's first take a moment to understand what an API is and how it works. An API, or Application Programming Interface, allows different software applications to communicate with each other. It acts as a bridge between different systems, allowing them to share data and functionality. APIs typically use HTTP requests and responses to communicate. An HTTP request is a message sent by the client, such as Power Automate Desktop, to a server. The server in our example is ChatGPT. The request includes various details such as the URL, the type of request, GET, POST, PUT, etc., and any data that needs to be sent to the server. An example for the data we want to send is the question, for which we want to get an answer from ChatGPT. The server then processes the request and sends back an HTTP response, which includes information such as the status code, for example, 200 OK, 404 not found, and any data that was requested. The data in this case will be the answer of the question, what we sent using the HTTP request. So in simple words, the API allows different software to talk to each other. It does that by sending HTTP requests and receiving HTTP responses. This is what API in general means. Before we can start connecting Power Automate Desktop and ChatGPT, we need to generate an API key on the ChatGPT webpage. This key is used to authenticate the connection and ensure that only authorized users and applications can access the API. To generate an API key, you'll need to sign into the ChatGPT webpage and navigate to the API key section. To navigate, just click on your account name here, then select the option, View API Keys. On this page, you can generate an API key using this button. The key is generated. Please copy the API key and store it somewhere, because you cannot copy it again once you close this window. Be sure to keep this key secure, because the API key is a sensitive information, and should be handled with care, and should not be shared with anyone else. Now I have the API key. Let's navigate to Power Automate Desktop, to write the API key in the activity, that I want to use later. It's Invoke Web Service activity, that allows us to send an HTTP request and get an HTTP response. So, this activity is to communicate with ChatGPT. I will add the API key in the headers section. Let's complete this step here, before we go back to the API documentation. For that, I first have to write the header name, which is authorization. After that, I have to write the word bearer. Then the API key, what I already generated. The header is ready now. So, the header name is authorization. It's a bearer token, therefore I added the word bearer. After that, I have an empty space, then the API key. In this way, I can access ChatGPT. But why I added the API key here and in this way? Let's check the API documentation. I will navigate to documentation. Then to completions. This is the HTTP request that I want to use in Power Automate Desktop. Using this request, I can send questions to ChatGPT and get answers. On this page, you can find everything you need to send the request. Here there is a description for the request. Then I have the method, POST. And the URL, or the endpoint. After that, I have all parameters I have to use or I can use. For example, the first one is the model, which is a required parameter. This means, I have to use this parameter always, once I want to send an HTTP request. You can see the data type of this parameter. And also some description for the parameter. The same also for all other parameters. On the right side, we have an example for an HTTP request, how it should be used. As you see, I have the header authorization here. It's written as I did in Power Automate Desktop. We also have other information, what we have to set for the HTTP request. For example, the content type. Here is the request body. Below you can find an example for the response. What we will get is HTTP response for the request. Let's now start adding the information we need to power Automate Desktop. The first two parts I need are the method and the endpoint. Let's add both in the activity, invoke web service. Here I will enter the URL. And I will select the method post. For the content type I will use JSON instead of XML. This means, I want to set the request body in JSON format. But if you want to do that in XML format, then you don't have to change this type here. Now we have everything we need except the request body. Let's copy the body from API documentation. Here is the body in JSON format. Let's copy it. I will enter the body in this section. Let's now edit the values for the different parameters. I will write the number 2000 for max tokens, for example. But you can use the number you need. The maximum you can use is 4096 tokens. As value for the parameter prompt, I will write the question, for example this one. So, we can use this parameter to send the question, for which we want to get an answer. That's all I have to change in the body. So, the body contains now different parameters. For each parameter there is a value. Only the first parameter is required. The request is now ready. Let's check how the response should be. I want to store the response in variables, therefore I will use this option, which is already selected as default. Now under Advanced tab there are some options more, what we can use depending on our requirement. For now we only need to change one option here. Encode request body. It's already enabled, but it should be disabled. So, I will disable it. We don't need to change anything else here. And in the last section you can find the variables, what we will get as output from this activity. We have these three variables. The first one will contain the response headers. The second one contains the response. In our example, this variable should contain the answer of the question we sent. And the last variable contains the status code, to check whether the request was completed successfully. For example, status 200 means that the request is executed successfully. Now the activity is done and we have everything we need to send a request and get a response from ChatGPT. Let's now add display message activity to display the response we will get from ChatGPT. For the title I will use the status code variable. And the message will be the response. That's all we have to do for now. Let's run the process to check what happens. It's done. I got this message box. The title is 200, which means that the request is executed successfully. And the body contains the response. We have some information here in JSON format. But what we want to get from this response, is under choices, then text. Here we can find the answer for the question. Berlin is the capital of Germany. Let's now see how to get only the answer of the question from this JSON string. For that I will use the activity, convert JSON to custom object. Using this activity I can easier read the different parts from the JSON string. For this activity I only need to set the response variable, which contains the JSON string. The output of this activity will be the following variable. Now I will use the new variable instead of the old one, to get only the answer. I can do that as following. The answer is available under choices and text. Therefore I will add choices. This contains different elements. I only need the first element, which contains the element text, therefore I added 0. At the end I want to get the element text. In this way I will get only the answer, which is available under text element. Let's run the process again to check the new result. As you see, I got only the answer of the question. This is how to get an answer for your question using ChatGPT API. Let's now add a new activity for the process, to make it dynamic, so that we can add any question we need. For that I will use the activity, Display Input Dialog. Let's add a title and message for this dialog, for example the following. The input will be stored in this variable. Let's change the name to question, for example. So, now the question we will enter in the dialog will be stored in this variable. Let's now use this variable in the HTTP request, to make it dynamic. I will remove the question and use the variable instead. Please make sure you use the variable in this way, else it will not work. The flow is ready now. Let's run it and check how it works. I will write the following question for example. And here is the result. It's a description for HTML, what does it mean? Let's run the flow again and write another question. Here is the answer. It's an explanation for Power Automate Desktop. This is how to connect Power Automate Desktop with ChatGPT using an API. This request was only an example to show you how to connect both systems with each other. The next steps will be the following. How to use this API to improve our processes and make them more efficient. This is what I will do in the next videos. If you still have any questions about this video, or if you have any ideas how to use this API, please let me know. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching and have a great day.